Hello, my dear friends. So today it was my curiosity to explain once again what is the real sense of spirituality. So I have given you 10 steps. If you want to become a spiritual person, so you need 10 steps. So let me explain these 10 steps. I hope I am visible as well as I am audible. If I am audible, so please like this video broadcast as well as we can have some discussion on the topic of spirituality or anything which comes in your mind for your personality development and your conceptual clarity, because when we have clear thoughts, so we have clear actions. So thoughts are very important. You know, if you have clean, straightforward thoughts, then your words and your actions will be also very clear, very meaningful, and you are on the way towards your spirituality. So I would like to see you people involved in this session. I have given you the 10 steps above, and if you can tell me what is the step number 1 in the comment box, so I can see it, and this way we can explain. So if there is any assistant here in this session on spirituality, so I will be highly grateful, and this way everybody is involved. This will be a comprehensive session, and I would like to see who is the person going with me in this session. Though this is too late at night, but let's see. So Fawad Aliya will be proceeding. But can you tell me what is step number 1 of spirituality? Now, step number 1 of spirituality, that is to know the definition of the word spiritual. The word spiritual is totally misunderstood. People, they do not understand what is spiritual. Different people have different concepts of spirituality, but my concept of spirituality, and many people now agree on this definition, that spirituality comes from spiritual, spiritual comes from spirit, and spirit means energy. So if you are energetic, dynamic, active, vibrant, so you are spiritual. You are spiritual. Thank you, Vaniza Jihan. To know what's spiritual, spirit means energy. So energetic and spiritual are synonymous. No energy, no spirit. So no spirituality. A spiritual person will be dynamic, active, vibrant, and never lazy. Now you tell me that, thank you Ren also, you have given me the requisite, the first prerequisite to be spiritual. So are you dynamic, energetic, or you are a lazy kind of person? So if you can find your spirit, if you can find your energy source and you can touch it, so congratulations, you are spiritual. Now, what is the prerequisite of number 2? What is number 2? Let us see. Now we understood that to be spiritual means to be spirited. Spirit means energy. Spirit means energy. If you are highly energetic, for example, I am speaking with energy, so I am spiritual because my spirit is there. If I am speaking lazily, without spirit, without spark, without involvement, without force, without power, so then I am not spiritual. So we understood number one. Now let us go to number two. What do you mean that if you want to be spiritual? Because spirituality comes after physicality, mentality, emotionality, and the last stage is spirituality. So your spirit, your deep inside personality, your soul is very deep. So you have to go from your body. From your body, you have to go to your mind. From mind, you have to go to your heart. And then from heart, you have to go to your soul. So you become very, very deep. So I don't see our prerequisite number two in the comment so far. So that is when you go beyond your animal stage. Because we are all animals. We have our animality, our physicality. We need to eat our physiological needs. We need to eat. We need to drink water. We need to procreate children. And we also need to sleep. So these are physicalities. Questions will be at the end. Mr. Zeeshan Tatal, let me complete my 10 prerequisites first. You are deep kind of person. You are always meaningful and your life is guided by a core set of values like Aristotelian 16 virtues. Aristotle, that is a very famous philosopher, and Aristotle is the founder of all branches of knowledge. If it is biology, botany, zoology, if it is physics, if it is chemistry, if it is psychology, if it is sociology, if it is philosophy itself, so it goes to Aristotle. So he has given us a list of 16 virtues which you can Google later. And if you have some core values, you have some principles, you have some list of virtues that you follow, then you are spiritual. Thank you, Vanisa, for your assistance. Now, because I don't see those 10 prerequisites. Now, number three may be that animal thing, that we have our physiological needs that is necessary. Otherwise, that is survival of the fittest. If we do not eat, drink, sleep, and we do not continue our generations in the form of reproduction, procreation, so the human race will stop. That's why we have Wasim, please be quick. Now give me number three. Number three, which is number three. Now number three for spirituality, Vanisa and Wasim, thank you for your assistance. Please continue keeping in view, because I'm not in Pakistan, so it reached to me a bit late. However, we are now understanding that we are more than animals. Animals have body, they have appetite, they have hunger, they have some instincts, but they do not use their mind, if there is any mind or any brain. Do they have brain, but they do not use it like human beings. Because human beings are rational animals, human beings are social animals, and human beings are talking animals. According to Aristotle, we have these three distinctions. So we have to understand these three distinctions. Now, the next prerequisite that we have, and you never hate, thank you, Wasim, go quick. You never hate, you either love or you ignore. So you have no time to hate other people. You are abundantly a loving person. But if there is no situation of love, so you simply ignore and you discover your new dimensions of love. So now, number three, we have gone. Now please come to number four quickly, so that I finish these 10 prerequisites to be a spiritual person. if you are spiritual, you will never hate. If you are hating, it means that you are not spiritual. Hate and spirituality can't go together. That is very, very important, very, very simple. You must read these 10 prerequisites if you are interested to be a spiritual person. If you just want to have a life of animal, so no need of spirituality. Just eat, drink, sleep, be merry, and that's all right. Now, number 4, you want to do something bigger than the animals. Your life is not just for eating, drinking, sleeping, and procreating. Procreating means producing children. You go beyond that. Now come to number 5. Let us see what is the 5th prerequisite to be a spiritual person. Let us promise today that in this session, if we are interested in spirituality, so we will be adopting these 10 features. Otherwise, it is impossible or it is very difficult to be spiritual. We started our understanding of spirituality from the word spirit, and spirit means energy. I will be taking your questions at the end of this session, and then we will be finishing this session after. Let me explain all these 10 points. If you have any suggestion, any criticism, if you want to improve, if you add some other ingredient for spirituality, so you can also tell me that. Please, Wasim and Vaniza, keep on pasting, copying, pasting the prerequisites. Number 5, even you are a child in the age of 50, you maintain your childlike innocence, truth, energy, curiosity, and sense of wonder. You want, like a child, you have tremendous energy and you are asking questions. You are innocent, you are truthful, and you sense of wonder. Oh, really? In this, your responsibilities of life do not take away the spirit of childhood from you. A spiritual person will be like a child. That is very, very important. A spiritual person will be like a child. So if you feel like a child, you are spiritual. According to Nietzsche, a very famous philosopher, you can be a lion, you can be an elephant, you can be a hero, but the real person when you are a child, so that is your reality. Please keep on past. Now number 6. You are an extremist in the sense of abundance. You want too much as your ability to do work or energy is enormous. Keep on number 7, 8, 9, and 10. I will be reading it. Now, you want abundance, too much, because you have tremendous energy. Like now, this hour, 2:30 a.m. in the morning, I am here live. I am discussing with you these things because my energy is enormous. My ability to do work is enormous. I can do a lot. This is why I am spiritual. And I want more. I want more and more. I am not happy with less, because I want abundance. I want a lot of things in my life. Why? The next point, number 7, will be explaining it. Because you are learning a lot. What you learn, you apply, you accomplish, you become a famous person. And once you are no more in this world, so you leave legacy. For example, this one video can be my legacy. If tomorrow I die, I am no more in this world, maybe for 1 year, 2 years, people will be scrolling down my Facebook page or my timeline, and they will be seeing that what Naeem Khan was talking to us. So that is my legacy. This formula is called lawful. Because your energy won't stop on lesser milestones. If you become just you get a job or business or some small thing and you are happy. No. You will continue learning its application, accomplishment, you become famous. Fame is very important. If you are not famous, so you are not successful and you are not spiritual. A spiritual person must be famous. If you go to the graveyard of Peshawar and you see the grave of Rahman Baba, you will be finding thousands of people there. There are so many other graves, but nobody goes there. Because Rahman Baba, he left a legacy. You learn, you apply, you accomplish, you become famous, and you leave legacy. So this is number 7. Now, number 8. You become intuitive and transcendental by going through the stages of rationalism and empiricism. You have keen interest in the topics of science, spirituality, philosophy, art, and law. Now, these are two formula. Very, very important formula. Rati and Spall. Try to understand it. Some people, they want to do everything right now. Everything should happen to me. This is called intuitionism, intuitive. You want that the things should come to me, a lot of wealth, a lot of knowledge, a lot of energy, success. So this approach is called intuitionism. And then you become transcendental. Transcendental means to go beyond. For example, you are sitting on a bank of river and you are enjoying your river, the flow, the waves, or you are in a jungle, birds, you are enjoying literature, music. So this is called transcendentalism. You go beyond the things, transcendental. These two stages are very good, but you must become empirical. Empirical means experimental, practical. And you must become rational. Rational means using your mind. So if you use your mind, you use your senses, you enjoy natural beauty, literature, music, and then you become intuitional, then the things come to you, you become miraculous. These stages are important. Nothing will happen to you automatically. You have to create the environment by rationalism and empiricism. And you are highly interested in the topics of science, spirituality, philosophy, art, and law. Then you can become spiritual. So this was number 8. Now is planning number 9. Please prepare your questions. I will be now answering your questions. You have clear vision. Clear. Your vision of life. Your mission, your objective, strategy, and action plan. We call it Vimosa. Vimosa. And you are fully aware of your strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. This is called SWOT. You are a clear person. You know what you can do, what you can't do. What are your opportunities and what are your threats? Strengths and weaknesses are internal, inside you. Opportunities and threats are external, outside. And number 9, you have clear vision. That is already I have explained. Now number 10, the last one. You know clearly that H is equal to V promise. H is happiness. If you want to be happy, you must have wealth, well-being, environment, philosophy, pleasure, relationship, outlook on life, involvement, success, and elasticity. For example, you want to become happy right now in this live session, so you get yourself involved. You write a comment, you ask a question, and you describe some situation, you give some examples. So after the session, you are not just listening, you get yourself involved and you got happiness. Elasticity means flexibility. You are a flexible person, you do not have rigidity. Your environment is great, you have philosophy of your life, you enjoy your pleasure, your relationships, your friendship, your family, your outlook on life that is more realistic, that is more optimistic. So if you have all these things, then you are a happy person. So these were the 9 prerequisites to be a spiritual person. Now if you have any question, I will add self-awareness, because without self-understanding, actually self-awareness, that is your spirituality automatically. When you are learning, you are applying, you are accomplishing, you are becoming famous, and you leave legacy, so automatically you are self-aware. That is already covered in the spirituality. However, it is a good point that you should be self-aware, self-actualization. That is my buzzword all the time I am using. When you are self-actualized, So you are automatically spiritual. Now, what is the difference between actualization and realization? Realization is the first step towards actualization. Actual is more real than real. Real, maybe your idea in your mind, that is also real. But when you make it really practical, pragmatic, then that is called actualized, actualization. More than self-awareness, I prefer self-actualization. Actualization is basically a practice. That is a process, a procedure, action. You become active. Then you really make it actual. You may realize something, but you may not actualize it. So there is a huge difference between actualization and realization. And then self-awareness, your self-concept, your self-efficacy, your self-efficiency, and your self-confidence, your self-esteem, all these things are interrelated. Explain number three again. What is number three? Can you tell me number three? Let me see it. Number three. Anybody who can tell me again, or I'm going up to see number three exactly. What is number three? You never hate, you either love or you ignore. You know, love and hate, these two are important emotions. We love something means that we accept that thing as it is. That is the definition of love. Love can be intellectual love. You love something intellectually, spiritually, physically, emotionally. There are so many kinds of love. So love is positive energy. Love is affirmative. Love gives you energy. Love makes you spiritual. In love, there is no failure. If there is any failure, if there is anxiety, stress, then that is not love, that is a disease. So if you are at the disease stage, there is some toxic relationship, some people are not responding the way you want. So then instead of hating, instead of the opposite of love, you just simply ignore, find your passion, move on and start your next love. Because there is no first and last love. This is totally wrong. Love can be 1,000 loves. You can love 1,000 people. You can love 1,000 objects. You can love 1,000 flowers. You can love 1,000 songs. So there is no this first and last kind of concept. So go to the next love. Never start hating the same thing that you were once loving. Now let me go to the... Thank you, Wasim Yasin Ren, for your cooperation. I already explained number three. I don't see any other question. If there is any question, so please go ahead. I'm here for 2-3 minutes. My message for you is that today you promise to be spiritual. And once you are energetic, that is the first stage that you are becoming spiritual. Because if you are, in a sense, if you are not energetic, if you are lazy, lethargic, you are procrastinating, you are not consistent, you are not perseverant, you are not ambitious. So it means that you are not spiritual. Spirituality will make you highly active person, active. But you enjoy, you are happy, because happiness, the ingredient number 10, that is so important. You must be a happy, smiling person. You must have a good outlook on life. And then you can have your spirituality. Samiullah says that, sir, as I told you that if there is hurdles, problems, then how will become energetic? Yeah. So I told you that for happiness, V is equal to H is equal to V promise. So in the V promise, there is one E. And that E is environment. If you are in China and you have some unfavorable circumstances, so that is a real issue. And you have to change your environment. Otherwise, you cannot become happy. There is no magic with me that I can say, oh, become happy. No, that is not possible. Because SPAL, double S-P-A-L, The first S stands for science. Science means systematicity, objectivity, organization. That everything must be organized, verified, everything must be properly observed. You use your senses, your experimental nature, you go through experience, you make a law, you make a theory, you make a formula. This is called science. So for scientific things, you have to create yourself. You have to come forward and change your environment. That may be by immigration, that may be by migration, that may be by transportation, that may be by traveling, that may be, you know, whatever you can do. But if you are not happy, you have to change your environment. Otherwise, in a, you know, a kind of non-productive, non-congenial environment, your environment must be congenial, conducive, productive, which can give you happiness, which can boost, which can make you spiritual. Otherwise, there is no spirituality and you may have problems in your life. So Muhammad Zeeshan Tatal says, sir, you are a great example of spirit, energy and love because of this time of night. Yeah. So this is my, you know, by chance I came at this time, 3 p.m. I think, 3 a.m. 3 a.m. in Pakistan. So, you know, this is something great. And I want to exemplify, I want to make it an example that you can be energetic at 3 a.m. as well. Because once you are spiritual, you are 24 hours spiritual. There are no ups and downs of spirituality. That in the morning you are spiritual and then at the afternoon you are not spiritual and you need a cup of tea to be spiritual or you need something else to be spiritual. No. The 10 ingredients that I explained, these are important to be spiritual. So be spiritual, be happy, be successful, enjoy life. Let us promise today with great strength, power, energy that from today onward we will be spiritual. We will do our analysis, what is missing in the 10 ingredients and how can we continue to be happy, successful, spiritual people. All the best. Take care. Yeah, I see some question now. This is Zeeshan is a very important young life coach. So he says they talk little about lifelong learning. Don't skip single second without learning. Yeah, learning. I'm doing great, Waqar Khan, but I want that you do great. Because my project is the project of leadership. I do not want followers. I do not want millions of followers. I want 1,000, maybe 100 followers. And that's all. But they all should be leaders. I may be a senior leader. They may be junior leaders, but leadership. So learning, that was the first lawful, our formula for spirituality, that is lawful. So the first L stands for learning, and learning has no end. But remember, learning is counterproductive. Books are counterproductive. Teachers are counterproductive, who just keep you on learning and you do not apply it and you do not accomplish. And then you do not become famous. And then you do not leave legacy before you die. I do not want that learning. Learning, whatever you learn. Like today you learned 10 ingredients, 10 prerequisites to be spiritual. You learned it, now apply it. Accomplish your goals. Be famous. And then leave legacy. That kind of learning. So all the best, guys. Thank you very much. It was a nice discussion. And I just wanted to explain these 10 important points. Please read these 10 important points. Listen to this audio video broadcast again so that you become totally clear, because vision is very important. For mission, you must have vision. And for objectives, you must have mission. And for strategy, you must have objectives. And for action plan, you must have strategy. This is called VMOSA. All these things are interrelated. And let me finish this video broadcast on one final point, that the real truth of life is interconnectedness. everything is interconnected, connectivity. If you have one, then you can have two. But if you do not have one, you cannot have two. So everything depends on others. Interdependence, interconnectedness, connectivity, that is the secret of life.